the unmistakable blush of love, the glow of pregnancy, the fulfilling look of a task well done, the excitement of a lost first tooth, the wonder of a child grasping something for the first time, the satisfaction of finally arriving home. Our faces are often very telling, and others may inquire, "So what's going on with you?" Or, "You have something to tell." God created our faces to be a reflection of our spirits, and it's a blessing when we never learn to hide them. Encounters with God really leave amazing expressions on our faces. Like when we first figured out that Jesus Christ is our Lord. Or when God speaks to us in a desperate time of need. Or when God directs us in a new way, even when we are unsure of our own capabilities. I would imagine that the face of Moses looked like a road map of his encounters with God. God had spoken to him through a burning bush, strengthened him with the task of freeing the Israelites from bondage and guiding them through easy and hard times. When the waters parted at the sea, and when water sprang forth a desert rock, at Mount Sinai, the mountain of God, Moses had a prolonged encounter with God. In their conversation about the rules with which the people were to live, God spoke directly to Moses, face to face on that mountain. And we are told that the glory of God covered Moses. That glory not only covered him, the glory became one with him, and it showed on his face. At one point in the story, it tells that Moses' face glowed so brilliantly that he had to wear a veil because the brightness was blinding. I really treasure that image, that we would be so bright with the glory of God that it would shine through us. Mountaintop experiences are frequent throughout the Bible and in our own lives as well. There's something about being on a mountain, a kind of purity and clarity that happens there. Moses' experience is very dramatic. God chose the mountain as a place where the laws and commandments would be conferred. God made Moses to come up the mountain, farther up than the people were allowed to come, farther up than the leaders were allowed to come, farther up than Moses' assistant Joshua was allowed to come. Moses went further up. And as Moses met alone with God, the mountain was covered with this huge, thick cloud, and the people at the foot of the mountain waited for Moses' return and saw the cloud. And then they saw what looked like a fire, an all-consuming fire. And while the people had to maintain a certain distance, it was also important that they they saw what was going on that mountain. It was important that they saw the cloud indicating the presence of God and the authority that God was bestowing upon Moses. The cloud, you see, was a buffer between the glory of God and themselves, because the glory of God in all its purity is much too much to take in. And later, in their sacrificial burnt offerings, the smoke that would rise from the offering would remind us and remind them of the cloud on Mount Sinai. And the incense that some Christians use in worship today reminds us of the presence of God. The purpose of the meeting between God and Moses was to give Moses the stone tablets on which the commandments were written. "Come up to me on the mountain and wait there," God said, "and I will give you the stone tablets with the teachings and commandments which I have inscribed to instruct them." This one sentence in the book of Exodus is the only word we have that tells us that the stone tablets were written directly by God. Moses remained on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights, a number that is frequently repeated throughout the Bible. 40 is the symbolic number signifying spiritual purification and spiritual growth. It was a time that would challenge the people waiting below. For we'll learn next week that in that time, they would desecrate the covenant they had just took with God. Moses' relationship with Yahweh is marked by an access to the divine presence that is unequaled in all of Israel's history. Only one other had this kind of contact, and that was Jesus. Jesus, too, had a mountaintop experience that connected with his followers in a very dramatic way. Remember that Jesus and his disciples were steeped in the teachings of the Hebrew Bible. They knew this history so much better than we do, which is why it's important for us to learn it. And Jesus' transfiguration would mean more to them than we can begin to understand. Jesus took his closest friends, his assistants, up a mountain by themselves, just as Moses had. And the glory of the Lord appeared, that is, the presence of God. The light was blinding. Jesus glowed in that glory. His clothes became bright, more brighter than anything that the disciples had ever seen before. And on that mountain, in all that dazzling brilliance, Elijah and Moses appeared with Jesus. Elijah represented the prophets, and Moses the law. Why the prophets and the law, you might ask? That seems so, I don't know, Old Testament. At the appointed time, God became flesh and lived among us in Jesus. And Jesus Christ was the fulfillment of all the prophets' words and all the laws handed down on Mount Sinai. When Jesus taught us to love God and love others, he said, "On those two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." When he gave us the golden rule, he said, "For this is the law and the prophets. Jesus was not some outlier event that burst through our lives. Jesus was the culmination, the completion, the final command of the God who created us, freed us, has sustained us over and over again. Jesus is the glory of God. One of the beloved songs of the last 30 years was written by a Christian musician from Columbus, Ohio, Lainey Wolfe. He wrote the words and the music. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angel wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. You know it? Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can see his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angel wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. This is the experience that we share with others.